Hello! Hello, hello, hello. Magandang gabi sa inyong lahat. Hinahabol natin yung oras para ma-shoot ko yung reading for today. So, this is just going to be very, very short. So, binabati ko kayo ng magandang gabi. So, eto na naman po ang inyong natural MD. And as you can see, medyo malikot ako kasi I'm in a very awkward position. I'm kneeling down, okay? So, these sacrifices gagawin ko para sa inyo. No? Para meron tayong napag-uusapan every day. So, hindi ko na papakita sa inyo itong room na to because it's quite small and there's nothing to see here. So, maybe tomorrow we'll start early. But tonight, first, as usual, kakamustahin ko ang inyong araw. To share myself naman, medyo very busy kami. And excuse dun sa mga tunog. Maliit kasi tong room, no? Eh, so very busy kami, so we went to meet Patrick's uncle kasi pa uwi na siya sa Canada, so medyo konting hello lang. And because of the COVID, kahit nandito siya, kahapon today ko lang siya nakita since dumating siya. So Tito Joe, I know you will be reviewing this, so I wish you a happy safe trip. Na? Happy safe trip sa iyong pagbalik sa Canada and hope to see you back. Dahil ikaw naman ay pabalik-balik, no? And that's a good life for you. So, and then after that, we went to Tagaytay to meet somebody and then we checked in dito sa hindi naman to hotel, this is an Airbnb. Okay? And then we went to a birthday party. So I'd like to wish happy birthday, 60th birthday to one of the pillars of my mother club, the Makati Golden Lions Club, Charter President Vicky Gragas. Happy birthday po sa inyo and thank you so much for the invite. I hope you enjoy your andas, ang aming kaunting regalo para sa iyo. Because of course it's pandemic. Maganda yung ating hand sanitizer, at saka because it's malamok, no, dyan sa Cavite, so meron kayong all-natural dengue away spray. And all your bisita has that, no? So, thank you. And ang ganda ng kanta mo kanina. Don't cry out loud. Pero tingnan natin what is the reading for tonight. Hi, Lion Marizen. Hi, Imbingbing. Hi, Sister Pinky. No, kamusta kayo ni Brother Cesar? Good evening. Yes, we'll be reading from this book, Wisdom from Above. Today is February 26. Sabi ng reading, stay out of it. In Tagalog, alis ka dyan. Stay out of it. Huwag kang makisali. Yun. Pagka sinabing stay out of it. Proverbs 26:17 says, like one who grabs a stray dog by the ears is someone who rushes into a quarrel not their own. So malinaw, huwag kang makisali. Stay out of it. No? It is extremely difficult to watch someone you love be wronged and hurt by others. Totoo naman. You may want to jump into the fray, take sides, plead his or her case, and add your input about the situation, safeguarding your friend or family member from further distress. So, ibig sabihin na makialam. However, be warned. The Lord may have an important purpose for the conflict that you are not aware of. Ganda. So even the conflicts daw na biglang dumarating sa buhay natin eh, the Lord has a purpose. So sabi, stay out. Huwag ka sumali. This proverb likens rushing into someone else's quarrel to grabbing a stray dog by the ears. When you do so, you're aggravating an unfamiliar canine without reason. You do not know the history of the dog or how it responds to stressors, so it's likely you'll get hurt in the process. Likewise, the Lord may have allowed this trial in your loved one's life for an unseen but crucial purpose. And when you wade into the battle without understanding what is going on, you may unintentionally hinder His work in them. So, ibig sabihin, sometimes, nagbibigay ang Diyos ng lesson. Ngayon, kapag ka sumasali ka doon sa scenario, maybe ikaw yung nagiging dahilan kung bakit hindi nalalearn totally or fully yung lesson that the Lord wanted to give. So, kaya sabi, no? You may unintentionally hinder His work in them, provoking Him to take action against you. Pwede, usually nga po, yung mga nakikisawsaw at nakikisali, sila nga po ay napapaasali sa away. At the end of day, sila yung kagalitan, no? Then you won't be fighting those who are hurting your loved one. You'll be waging war against God Himself. And that never turns out well. Okay? So, ultimately, the Lord is a greater, more powerful, and wise defender than you are. So be assured that your loved ones are safe in His hands. You don't have to shield them from quarrels or conflicts, and you should never try to fight for them. Instead, faithfully pray for and support them, always spurring them on to godly conduct and faith in the Lord. By doing so, you're sure to observe God's interest as well as theirs. So at the end of the page is a short prayer that goes like this. Lord, this conflict in my loved one's life grieves me, but I trust You to safeguard and teach them through this. Please show me how to encourage them to stay faithful to You. Amen. So in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Good evening, nagmamadali. No? So yes, stay out of it. So, pag may nag-aaway o merong nangyayari, no, at feeling mo kawawa naman yung kamag-anak mo o yung kaibigan mo o yung mahal mo sa buhay kasi may nakagalit or going through a situation na medyo mahirap, sabi, stay out of it. Number one, hindi mo alam kung anong nangyari. So, shut up. I mean, shut your mouth. Huwag kang makialam. Be quiet. And then, number two, if they're going through a situation, let them learn. Perhaps the Lord is trying to teach them something. Kasi pag na makialam ka, sabi dito sa libro, anyway, libro lang naman na ito yung nagsasabi, eh baka ang kalaban mo eh si Lord. Ibig sabihin, babalik yung ginagawa so that matuto ka. Sabi kasi, huwag kang makialam. So, magkakaroon ka ng leksyon. No? And in the end, marirealize mo, sana nga po hindi ako sumali doon. Sana hindi ako na makialam doon. So, because there is always a lesson that the Lord is trying to teach your loved one, your friend, your relatives, or the other person. That's why it's going through. So, in this life, focus on yourself. Focus on your future. Focus on your own home. Huwag kang makialam. Na? Now, yun lang po. Kasi medyo I'd like to take this time din naman para makapahinga tayo. It's been a long day for me. Kaya, with that, tapos na ang first sharing ng Wisdom from Above. Need I say more? Ang sabi ni Lord, huwag kang makialam. Pag-pray mo na lang na sana maayos nila yung situation, maayos nila kung ano man yung mga nangyayari sa kanila para hindi na sila mabother. And in the end, pag-pray natin na they learn their lesson. You and I, we have experienced those kinds of things one way or another. Maybe ako kahapon or kanina. Or yesterday, or maybe ikaw today. So, Just be quiet, lift it up to the Lord, try to learn the process and the lessons, no, that comes with the conflict or the problem. Kasi you will always learn something from it. Just keep a positive note. So, the second naman part of the lesson for today is that, yes, I went into a party, and that was a beautiful party. May question ako, pag po ba nakita ko dito yung pangalan ninyo, pagkatapos may nakalagay na wave, ibig po bang sabihin nagwe-wave ka ako or i-click ko to para mag-wave ako ba? Ah, you wave. Okay, I'm waving. Hello, hello, hello. Hi, Lay. I miss you. I miss you sa garden ng Rockwell. No? I hope to see in the garden ang dami kong plants. And then, kwentuhan tayo. Okay, so my second part of the sharing as your doctor, natural MD is, of course, I went into a party and a party has liquor or alcohol. No? So, alam ninyo, alcohol is not really part of our body system. It dangers the kidney, the pancreas. It dangers your liver. And plus, alcohol is not really, should not be part of your body. Kaya nga, kapag umiinom ka nun, natitipsy ka, kapag sinobrahan mo pa, nagkakaroon ka ng imbalance. No? And alcohol is the main source of pancreatic cancer. So, yun. And liver cancer. So, there are many, many reactions to alcohol. Some people, okay lang sa kanila. Pero some people, alam nyo ba, are allergic to alcohol. They're allergic to this type of beverages kasi it's really not supposed to be part of your body, no? You're not really supposed to be taking in alcohol. So, each person has a unique response to alcohol intake. Some may have allergies. Yung iba, nangangate. Yung iba, nagpa-flash. Ibig sabihin, namumula. Yung iba, nagpa-palpitate, hindi makahinga. Yung iba, they feel very, very warm. Yung iba, they feel hard on the chest. No? Yung iba naman, they get headache. No? And then yung iba, blurring of vision. So, madaming yan. If you think you have any signs of this, please refrain from taking alcohol kahit konti lang. You know why? Because number one, the main detoxifier of all of the food that you take in your mouth, in lahat orally, no, is your liver. What happens to your liver? Nasi-strain mo siya. So instead of your liver metabolizing the food that you eat, inuuna niyang i-metabolize yung alcohol kasi mabigat yon. So what happens to your liver? So, nahihirapan siya. What happens to the mga food na supposedly na-metabolize siya? So, syempre, hindi niya nagagawang maayos yung kanyang trabaho. Then, tingnan ninyo, yung mga taong umiinom ng alak, mas lumalaki, mas tumataba. So, totoo lang, no? At kapag nagsimula na silang pumayat, may sakit na po sila. So, that's it. I have nothing against alcohol. I'm trying to stop myself from drinking because I want to lose weight, no? And at the same time, after my COVID, I've been experiencing nosebleeds. Kaya, I think maybe if I stop drinking alcohol, then I'd be taking care of my liver better. Because, you know, the liver also produces clotting vitamin K, that is good for clotting para hindi tayo nagbi-bleeding. So, I'll be taking care of myself like that. So, I hope you learned something from me this evening. It's really deep. No? Malalim yung pinag-usapan natin. Pero, just the same as the book says, stay out of it. Stay out of alcohol. I love you all. Good night. Bye-bye. See you tomorrow.